Everything that fell in the river naturally goes downriver, and that means it goes through the town of Guthrie. That's where Eyewitness News 5's Kevin Sims is joining us now live. And Kevin, a lot of problems there as well. The recovery is underway. Thankfully, the drying process is now beginning as well.
Tyler, you hit the nail on the head. This is actually an improvement over what we've seen earlier. This is Highway 33 looking back off to the east here. Now, this is where they've had it shut off because actually Cottonwood Creek flows underneath that bridge. But this morning when it went out of its banks, it's not only where it was now, it's all the way down here to the south. This is where the creek flows to the south. Now, looking back, we're going to look off into the sun all the way back here to the west. You see where those folks are way down there? That's where the creek was up and flowing earlier tonight. I'm going to keep circling around. You see this Bar Mac Black Angus Cafe right there? I went in and talked with the folks inside. They had mud on their floors. The chairs outside are on those rollers, and mud had completely covered the chairs back down there on those chairs. We're going to keep turning around. This really is a live tour, 360 degrees here in Guthrie. This church up here, Grace Church, Grace Christian Church. See the pickup truck down there? That's right. All those intersections are still flooded. I walked up in there, talked to some folks. It did not get into the church, but there's a building back behind that they are inside mopping up. They've got hoses. They've got rubber boots up to their knees trying to get all the mud. Now, the fear here is, Tyler, is that the Cottonwood Creek flows north into the Cimarron River. What happens if the Cimarron River gets full? Well, they might have this entire problem all over again. That's why they're going to stay out here and watch and wait. We're live in Guthrie. Kevin Sims, Eyewitness News 5.